So our suspicion was confirmed. The Imo State governor has embarked on such an act of hate and misrepresentation and misinformation concerning members of my family. But shockingly enough, I also had to call the police commissioner of police, who has just recently confirmed to me a few hours ago that the order came from Abuja. So I wondered if this order actually came from the Inspector General of Police. And if it is, I'm sure the Inspector General of Police must have been misinformed. But I'm yet to see what kind of offense Oluchenwosu have committed to warrant this discretion of the church and sporadic shootings that has left a lot of people injured. I want to request for the first and last time that security agencies, presidency must look into what is happening in Imo State. Vis-a-vis as it relates to the government of Imo State and members of my family. This family has gone through a lot. Insult and humiliations and threat to life from the government of Imo State. But I'm yet to understand what must have informed the kind of level of misinformation that must have led the IG to give such directives. Because the IG, I know, wouldn't direct any policeman to go to church and shoot and arrest innocent citizens. I feel that enough of this is enough. And Hope Uzodinma has been in the business of trying to get any member of my family or myself involved in this kind of his wicked acts of hatred. I think enough of this is enough. And I've called all people's concern on this matter. And I hate to make this very public, but I'm being tempted to say the facts as they are. I don't want the police to get involved. I don't want the APC government led by Buhari to get involved in a matter like this that will tarnish the image of the Federal Republic of Nigeria. Why should police go to the church to arrest people and arrest individual innocent person? What is the story they have written about him? I'm waiting to hear the story. But I can assure you this will be a political motivated and cooked up story now. They're going to come up with. This is one arrest too many has led to me and members of my family. There was just no justifiable reason for the police to have gone into the church to carry on such shooting exercise. Even the security attached to my family could not because they identified the policeman. Why go to the church? Why is he shooting? Why do you have to drag the innocent boy on the floor? Why do you have to beat him up? Why do you have to push my wife? Why do you have to push my daughter? Why have to tear their clothes? There was no single arrest warrant on Uchenwosu. Nothing at all. It was like a kidnap. If not for the fact that we have confirmed that it is police, the initial fear that this was unknown gunmen that has come to kill Uchenwosu. But I don't know. The Uchenwosu I know, I don't know what story will be fabricated against this young man.
Most state government is aware of the disgusting, very disgusting utterances that were made today by former governor of this state, Rochas Okorocha. And it's marks of clear panic. It looks clearly to us that he's in a panic, in a frenzy. He's in a panic because it looks like the law is gradually closing in on him. And it's expected that he will panic because the guilty is always afraid. So one is not surprised the way he's talking incoherently. If you listen to him, You find a man who is panicking, talking very incoherently. First, he says that police came into the church shooting, and then the wife approached police shooting, and she was not hurt. It doesn't make sense to anybody. And then he says that they saw government house vehicles, which confirmed that His Excellency Governor Obuzi Odumasan was in the arrest. You know, but he didn't tell us which number. If he was sane enough and in a good state of mind, with all the sporadic shooting he claimed, to see government house number, he should have quoted at least one government house number, so that people can verify. In the same breath, he also says that he called the commissioner who said the order came from Abuja. Yet he's still accusing the state government, and then he's saying that the Inspector General of Police must have been misinformed. What is surprising is that if a man is innocent or feels no guilt, and the police has said that we are in custody of this man, the next thing is to allow the due process to follow. What is the haste in this press conference, trying to politicize an ordinary thing, which always is just an indigene of Imo State and the citizens of Nigeria? And if he has run foul of the law, the police has every right to arrest him. And how they do it should not be, nobody should dictate to them how they do it. It depends on the gravity of the offense, and it depends on the information at their disposal. You know, you never can tell. Maybe they had that, maybe from there he's leaving for the airport going up. So they might decide to take necessary steps to make sure that they get him in their custody. But what is painful is that a former governor of this state, Rocha Sokorocha, is busy raining abuses on His Excellency, the governor of Imo State, and saying all manner of things about him. I don't want to join issues with him. And he's claiming that he doesn't know what he has done. He has not done anything except that he raped Imo State treasury. He raped Imo State resources. He raped Imo State people and looted their common patrimony. If he's still lacking any evidence to that effect, they recently recovered K.O. Mbadiwe University, built with over 40 billion of Imo State resources. Should be enough evidence. He should actually bury himself and his face in shame. And if he brings his family to you, then I say both himself and his family, they should bury their faces in shame. Because what they came to do in Imo State was to loot and steal the people's common patrimony. And because this government, ably headed by distinguished Senator Obuzi Odumma, is a government that believes in due process, that is why he has been taking his time to be able to recover these things. Roach has never believed in due process. He never respected the rule of law. However, I believe that no matter how slow the wheel of justice grinds, it will eventually and ultimately catch up with the guilty. And what former Governor Korocha has done today is only to confirm once again that he is guilty. Otherwise, why the panic? First of all, there were the people who started spreading the news, the rumor that it was an abduction gunman. And then later on, shortly after that, you are now accusing Imo State government. Even when you have confirmed in your own words that the Commissioner of Police confirmed to you that it was order from Abuja, from Inspector General of Police. What anybody who is not guilty and who is not in panic, all he's trying to do is to whip up unnecessary sentiment. But unfortunately for him, those days when he could take Imo people for a ride are gone. Because Imo people now know him as a man who came here and looted them dry. And honestly, in a civilized society, this man should not be walking about the streets free. He should not be talking the way he's talking. He should bury his face in shame, because it was a total disaster to Imo State. And that is why he's in a panic, because he doesn't know what next. If I were him, and if he's somebody who is sure of himself, what he should do is to wait for the due process of law to take his place. Thank God, nobody is taking the laws into his hands. If Uchenwosi is guilty of anything, the police has arrested him. The next thing is the next step, and they find out why has he been arrested. And if he committed the crime, of course he should face the wrath of the law, because he's not above the law. So what is the point of trying to whip up sentiment that is sure that this is part of his plan to name him and his family as those behind the banditry in Imo State? He's already indicting himself. So that is why I say he is guilty. And he's in a panic. He's in a frenzy. He's in a panic because he is guilty. And anybody who is guilty, that's the first thing, the first reaction is to panic and begin to talk incoherently as he's talking. As far as I'm concerned, if you listen to him as I have done, you will find that this man is in a panic and is talking incoherently. And that is not going to save, to stop the course of law to take his place. If Uchenwosu is guilty of anything, the law will take its course. And if Okorocha is guilty of anything, the law will take its course. So all these ones is shouting, talking about this, it's not going to serve him. What he should do, and what anybody who loves him should do, is to say, let the rule of law take its course. Not to whip up sentiments, talking about a political this and that and all this. If you politicize such a weighty thing, and mind you, for God's sake, we are facing a serious situation. Government has repeatedly said that the insecurity in the state is politically contrived. Assuming this is why Uchenwosu is arrested, I don't know, because the police will tell us eventually. So is that what we should do politics with?